Hi, I'm Dr. Michelle Lee, a board-certified ophthalmologist, and today we're going to talk about cornea abrasions, or scratches on the surface of the eye. The cornea is the clear outer layer at the front of the eye that helps your eye to focus light. The cornea is also a barrier against bacteria, viruses, dirt, and particles, and can filter out some harmful light. This layer of the eye is responsible for regulating the blink and tear reflexes, and the cornea is also the most highly innervated part of the body. So as a result, when there is an injury to the cornea, like a cornea abrasion or an ulcer, it is extremely painful. Cornea abrasions are typically caused by trauma or a tear to the outermost layer of the cornea. This can be due to mechanical trauma, like from eye rubbing or a poke in the eye, as a result of friction from contact lens wear, or foreign objects in or to the eye. There is also a common genetic cornea condition called map dot fingerprint dystrophy, where you may be at higher risk of a spontaneous cornea abrasion because the top layer of the cornea is only loosely attached to the rest of the cornea in this population. In any corneal abrasion, the symptoms can range from mild irritation to severe eye pain with foreign body sensation. Most cornea abrasions will cause sensitivity to light, a pink or red eye, and excessive tearing. If you think you have an abrasion, it is important for you to see an eye doctor. An abrasion is treated with antibiotic eye drops or ointment, and the type of antibiotic is dependent on what caused the injury in the first place. If the abrasion was caused by a dirty object or a contact lens, we usually want to use a stronger antibiotic, but for most clean abrasions, an antibiotic ointment is adequate coverage and soothing to the eye. There are two major complications from a cornea abrasion. If the abrasion results in an infection or a corneal ulcer, this will require medical treatment for weeks to months with stronger antibiotics and may result in a cornea scar with permanent vision loss. You will most likely need to remain under the close watch of a cornea specialist to make sure the infection is under control and to help with vision recovery once the infection resolves. Another complication of a corneal abrasion is recurrent corneal erosion, where the area does not heal well and may require a cornea procedure to smooth out the cornea. Regardless, if you think you have a corneal abrasion, it is important for you to get your eyes checked. A corneal abrasion may not start as a serious condition, but every devastating corneal ulcer starts out as an abrasion. Have you ever had a corneal abrasion? Let me know in the comments below. If you like this video, please like and subscribe to my channel. I release a new video every Saturday about eye health and disease. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!